Okay, so now we're looking at the front part of your of the bones in your neck, the so-called cervical spine, and there are about seven of them. There's a big ring on top, which helps your skull sit on your shoulders. Then there's C2, the second bone in your neck, which has kind of a toothy thing sticking up into C1, the so-called odontoid process. 3, 4, 5, C6, C7. And you'll note that in between each pair of bones, there's a little disc space in between. It's represented by this kind of gummy stuff, which is pretty much what discs look like. Okay, so the major blocks of bone, the so-called vertebral bodies, are these big, huge, strong structures that hold your head on your shoulders. Your head's about the size and shape and weight of a bowling ball. All right, and the discs in between allow these bones to move past each other when you're bending and twisting and extending your neck. Okay, that's the front view of your spine. Let's look at the back view of your spine. Okay, there's George. And what you see here, these kind of shelves of bone, the roof of bone that's sticking out there, and that's called the lamina, technical terms. You'll also note, by the way, that nature kindly provided little levers for your muscles to pull onto so you can turn your neck with a lot less effort. That's pretty neat, isn't it? Okay. So these little shelves of bone here, these laminae, cover the spinal cord, which is a nervous structure. It's the information superhighway between your brain and the rest of you, which sits in a water bag that runs all the way up and down your spine. Okay, so this is the main tube where your spinal cord is, all right? And then, because your spinal cord has to communicate with the rest of your body, when you want to scratch your nose, you got to like wiggle your finger, right? The spinal cord sends off these little shoots, these little nerves that come out, and this is what goes to your arms and in the lower part in your legs that allows you to move and feel sensations and stuff like that. And you will note, by the way, that these little nerves are coming out through a hole in the bones, kind of on the side. Now, the word for hole in Latin is foramen, so if you want to impress your friends, you say, I have a foramen in the knee of my jeans, okay? Then this little foramen, this little hole that the nerve uses to get out of your spine, sits in front of another little pair of joints over here on the side. You see that little pair of joints over here on the side? Okay, and that again, these are called the facet joints, and these guys just simply help your spine twist and turn and bend and flex, and gives you a little more mobility of your neck than if you just had joints like over here. So you got the front of your spine with the major blocks of bone, the vertebral bodies and the discs. You got the side part of your spine over here, which has the nerves running through a hole in the side of your spine that's just in front of these joints, which are the facet joints that help you bend and twist and flex and extend. And then way in back here in the back part of your spine, you have the lamina, the roof of bone over your spinal cord. And that lamina has little bitty attachments, little bitty flanges of bone sticking out that allow your muscles some mechanical purchase so you don't have to spend as much energy turning your head around. And that's a quick view of the spine.